I'm Chris Edwards and welcome to this week's Tennis Warehouse vlog. This week we're going to go over the anatomy of a shoe. So we're going to cover all the things as a tennis player you're going to want to know about the shoes you're wearing and the features they have that are going to help protect your feet. So I've grabbed a Lotto Ultra Speed, a Raptor right here, number 4. So let's have a quick look at this one, find out what's going on. We're looking at the upper of the shoe right now, and that really describes the material that wraps up around your foot. Pretty much most shoes are made of a synthetic material these days. There's a lot of TPU on there, a lot of other materials that are gonna add support, breathability. Mesh is very popular on upper materials as well. So let's have a look at the upper. Basically, we have the heel, the midfoot, forefoot, and then the toe. Starting at the heel of the shoe, come around, most shoes will have a heel counter. It's right in here. And that's gonna add some stability to the back of the shoe right there, really gonna help it lock in, support your heel in the shoe, and it's also gonna, when you come down and land, it's gonna stop you from, you know, bending the upper materials out and having the shoe collapse to the lateral side, which would result in an ankle roll. Really bad news right there, so you wanna avoid that. So all shoes will have that heel counter, and it's hidden in there, and then inside the heel, there'll be padding in there to protect your foot from the stiff counter material. Moving now, we're looking at what's called the lateral side of the shoe. And on this side of the shoe, we get to see the cushioning system and then also some of the support features in the upper. So underneath the heel, this one has a Synpulse cushioning system, very unique to Lotto. Typically, you'll see an EVA on Nikes. You're going to see an Air A6. You're going to see some gel cushioning. Most vendors have their own specific form of cushioning. And what that does is just going to absorb the shock as your foot comes down and impacts the court. Typically on a tennis shoe, the cushioning in the heel is going to be more elevated, and the cushioning in the forefoot up here is going to be a lower profile, get you low down, feeling very secure on the court for when you're doing that aggressive push off, and yet you have a more cushioned feel on the heel when you come down and make a tough landing. Let's move up to the forefoot of the shoe here, and you see this one has a nice support piece on the lateral side that's going to wrap up, and that's going to cup the side of the foot right there. And so when you make an aggressive lateral stop, say open stance forehand, or you've come out of a close stance ball shot, and then you're landing like that with the right foot, the back foot for a right-handed forehand, the foot is gonna slide inside the shoe towards the lateral edge of the shoe. And then both this TPU piece right here and then also this extra layer of upper material is gonna help hold the foot inside the shoe, stop the shoe from ballooning out. It's gonna give you a nice supportive ride right there. Let's have a look at the top of the shoe now. We get to see inside the shoe. This is the ankle collar of the shoe. Nice and padded on shoes today, so it's going to give you nice protection around the ankle collar, so you're not going to get any rubbing, poking, or pinching, or blistering from the back of the shoe. And it's a real sort of like high torque area. You know, the foot is really moving around, and so you want a nice padded shoe, and all good tennis shoes offer that right there. And we can also see inside the shoe, this one has the insole, and that's in there, and that's removable. You can pull that out, you can put a custom orthotic in there or a more supportive insole if you have any kind of arch issues. Talking about the arch of the shoe, if we go underneath the shoe, now you can actually see like part of the midfoot shank in there, and that's a hard piece of plastic inside the shoe. And what that does is it makes it very torsionally solid right here, very stable through the arch. It's gonna protect the arch, and it's gonna push the flex point of the shoe up here under the toe. So when the shoe flexes on toe off, you're really gonna want it to flex towards the toe of the shoe. If the shoe flexes back in here, that can damage your arch. So a good tennis shoe like this one is gonna flex nicely right up there under the toes. That's gonna protect your arch when you make that aggressive sprint forward to chase down a short ball, etc. Also from the top of the shoe, we can see the tongue. This one has a separate tongue, but there's also a unitongue design, and that is when the tongue is either one piece in here with the ankle collar or is stitched to it. That's called a unitongue design. This one is just a separate floating tongue. And again, nice padding on that, and there's some mesh through there, and that's gonna let the hot air escape and hopefully get some cold air in. Coming up to the front of the shoe right now, this area right in front of the lace system. So we have the laces, the ice days right here. And then right here, we call this part, it's just coming into the toe box of the shoe. This is called the vamp, and it's usually a breathable and very flexible material right here. So you see this one's perforated, and it's a nice pliable material, and that's gonna let the shoe bend nicely, and there's not gonna be any stiff upper materials that are gonna poke or pinch the foot as the shoe creases right there at the toe. moving right up towards the toe, and we have the toe bumper right here. And most tennis shoes, you're going to see a nice durable toe piece. And this one, not only does it protect the very tip of the toe, but as we come around and we're looking at now the medial side of the shoe, you see that toe bumper extends up and it comes right up to the lace system and comes down. And that's for the trailing foot on a slide. A lot of players are sliding, even on hard courts these days. And sometimes the trailing foot will tip over and this part of the upper is going to come against the court. And this is just some abrasion resistant material right there, part of the toe bumper, to help protect the upper from premature wear. Also, we're looking at the medial side of the shoe. You can see some additional perforations right here. And that's, again, just to allow the foot to breathe. And then another part of heel support right here coming up from the cushioning system into the heel counter just to help lock the foot in at the heel. Okay, let's look again at the underneath of the shoe. And this one has what's called a two-piece outsole. So it's the heel part of the outsole is separated right here from the forefoot and toe part of the outsole. Some shoes, especially mostly clay shoes, you'll see a one-piece outsole, and that is just to prevent clay from getting stuck in any deep grooves and clogging up the shoe. So clay shoes, you quite often will see a one-piece outsole, sometimes on a hardcourt shoe as well. This one is a multi-surface designed. It's going to work great on a hardcourt. On a clay court, you're typically going to want deeper grooves than this and a very aggressive, what's called a herringbone pattern, which is kind of like, it's very similar to the V's you'll see here. This right here, we call this the pivot point on the shoe, and that's just going to help your foot turn and pivot and move to the next ball. And then we have some nice flex grooves in here, and that's just going to help the thick rubber material of the outsole flex and move with your foot. The highest wear area for an aggressive modern player is going to be right up here on the inside of the, underneath the big toe, and that is because that shoe is going to get dragged like that on serves and on forehands. It's going to take a real beating right here. And so when we see outsoles wear out, it's typically right in this region right here. And so most manufacturers are really beefing up and adding some additional material, some rubber right there to the outsole of the shoe. And there it is again, looking at the lateral side. And that's a quick anatomy of a tennis shoe. Hopefully that was a nice, clear and concise little bit of information right there on the anatomy of a shoe. If you have any questions, be sure to just enter them right there on our YouTube channel and we'll get back to you and help you out. Thanks for watching.